It belongs to all of us, and it belongs to the people in Tahrir, and belongs to the people in Occupy Wall Street. Our next speaker, our brother Justin from Occupy Wall Street. Let's hear it for Justin.
Wow, I can't even tell you how humbling it is to be here. Mainly because I owe my comrades in Egypt a debt of gratitude. When I was listening about the tear gas, and when I was seeing it on Al Jazeera and Russian TV, it brought me back 12 years ago. I was on the streets of Seattle, Washington. It was a protest against the World Trade Organization, and it became a sea of tear gas and pepper spray and rubber bullets and concussion grenades and everything else they could unleash. And they used so much tear gas that they started using nerve gas, and that's probably what they were using with the convulsions when the sister was talking about the people who were going into convulsions. They were probably using a kind of nerve gas, because that was at the end of the Seattle demonstrations against the WTO. They used that too, but you never heard about that. And we were going for a long time shutting down meetings from the World Trade Organization to the IMF and World Bank. And then all of a sudden it all fell apart after 9/11 and the national security scares and everything. And for 10 long years I was waiting, just waiting and hoping people would show the nerve to get back out in the streets again, and to take back our democracy and to take back our lives. And then what I saw on TV with the uprising in Egypt, I knew something was coming again. I knew there was a time coming. And shortly thereafter, Occupy Wall Street came into being. Months before that, a friend put on my Facebook wall an ad for it saying to Occupy Wall Street, and I was like, yes, finally, it's coming. Wall Street has to pay for what they have done, the looting of the American people, the looting of this globe, and just the use of debt to keep us in slavery. And I feel an especial sense of responsibility as a U.S. citizen, not just for the tear gas that our companies make over here, but for the backing of the imperialist forces throughout the Middle East and throughout the world, and just our backing of the international financiers who are keeping all of us down, from Egypt to Greece to Yemen to everywhere. But they're not going to do it anymore, because there's more of us than there are of them. And remember that. There are more of us than there are. If we just stand united and just realize that we don't need permits, we are the ones who grant them the permits to be in power. And let's revoke that permit and do that now. And you people are beautiful, and I love my comrades from Egypt and Greece and everywhere else on the globe. And if we could just have half the heart that you people have to stand up, this country, this nation would be transformed from one shore to the next. And I love you all, and that's all I have to say. Thank you.
Thank you, Justin. Let's give it up to him from Occupy Wall Street. Now we're gonna chant a little bit in Arabic.
Yes.
Mashi?
Yes.
Can hear you. Mashi?
Yes.
Isha, Yuri, Iskad and Nizam. Isha, Yuri, Iskad and Nizam. Isha, Yuri, Iskad and Nizam. دم المصري مش رخيص اضرب نار اضرب حي يا مشير دورك جاي قول 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 ما تخافي العسكر لازم يمشي تكتب على حد الزنزانة حكم العسكر على الوخيانة طب حكم العسكر على الوخيانة دد البار ودد القوة دد مجلس المخلوع الحرية الحرية الدمور مش بلطجية الحرية الحرية التخلية بلطجية والله الحمسية أقدع منكم كلاتكم يا جماعة والله العظيم الحمسية عنا بمصر أقدع منكم لأن ما في حد يتجاوب معاكم يا جماعة صحابي يا حبايب بمصر أم الدنيا أنا سوري بس بحب مصر يا جماعة لا لازم نسكت يا أسر الحمد الدنيا نحن حلبية نستعد رسم السعادة يا عم علو الصوت مصرية مصرية
الشهداء ما بتموت
علوا الصوت
روح الشهداء ما بتموت
I'm even speaking with a Syrian accent. Mad at me. What I want to say, I would say a few words in Arabic and then I'll translate that in English. إحنا الجيش ومبارك كانوا دايما بيقولوا حجتهم اللي إحنا بنخلق فوضى. إحنا الناس اللي بينزلوا في التحرير دول بيخلقوا فوضى. عشان كده خلينا نقعد في بيوتنا. بس هم لو يعرفوا إن الفوضى اللي كانت موجودة قبل التحرير كانت موجودة أكتر. كانت موجودة في المساكن العشوائية اللي منهاش مجاري ولا مية. الفوضى كانت موجودة في السجون اللي بتحصل. الفوضى كانت موجودة في السرقة والنهب. لما حصل ميدان التحرير كان في أكتر من 1,000,000 إنسان في مكان واحد وما كانش فيه فوضى. النظام هو اللي خلق الفوضى والثوار هم اللي خلقوا النظام. I'll try to translate that in English. Always the excuse for the Mubarak regime and now the Tantawi that the revolution, the Tahrir, created a chaos. So this is why they ask people to stay at home. Because, you know, we don't want chaos. We don't want people in the street and blocking works and jobs and schools. But in fact, the government, Mubarak government and now Tantawi government, they are the ones who created the chaos. They are the ones who opened the prisons for, you know, for criminals to go and kill people. But actually the revolutions and Tahrir movement, they're creating a system without a system. They created a health department in Tahrir Square. They created an education and school in Tahrir Square. They created a system. No one was even harassed in Tahrir Square while there were millions. Also, our brother and sister here in Occupy Wall Street, they wouldn't occupy the streets and, you know, spread disease. They created the system. The chaos was already created by Wall Street, by people in the corporations who drove us to war and took a budget from education and healthcare. They are the one who created the chaos. They are the one who created, but we the one who created the unfair system for everyone. So this is a message for all the government in the world. The people, they are the one who wanted, who knows what they are good for us. But the government and the corruptions, most of them, unfortunately, they just do what they are good for a few people. So we have to say that for everyone. The people united will never be defeated. 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 Egyptians united will never be defeated. Will never be defeated. American United will never be defeated. Our next speaker is really a dear friend of mine. I really admired him. I called him my young and great brother. I wouldn't say the whole incident because he asked me not to say exactly what happened. But just to let you know that the Egyptian government, they don't only exist in Egypt. They exist here in embassies and consuls, and they want to divide us. And they try to divide us with our next speaker. But the head of the consul tried to tell him, you know, don't go with these people. Don't go with that. But he was man enough to tell him, you know what? You can't tell me that. And I will tell my brother and sister what you told about him. So without, you know, further details, let's hear it from my brother. Salah!
Hi, everyone. How are you doing? So tonight, I don't want to speak, actually. I want to conclude my, if you want to say it's a speech, I want to sing. And it's a hip-hop rap song for a team who's recently established in Egypt before the January 25th. And actually, this song that I'm going to sing right now is their song, but it really concludes a lot. So, guys, if you can do something, can go with the flow, okay? ده اللي كان ده اللي صار ده اللي عشنا كل يوم الحق طار الظلم عار وامتى تنزاح الغيوم عشان كده عملنا ثورة حرة كنا جوه طلعنا بره نفوس مناضلة كلامنا هيعدي المجرة قولوا اللي ما شافش يشوفه يخلي الخوف من قلبه لاغي حقي لو مش حاجي وبكلامك يتحاخده بدراعي وانا واعي لكل كلمة بقولها مش بخرف هتعرف لما تشوف اسم الريفولوشن بالذهب متزخرف بيقولوا الثورة في قلب الشعب ماتت بس انا شايفها زادت شايف غضب جوه قلبي شعب ساكت جوه قلبي جيل كامل واقف في مكانه ثابت عمال بيخبط في الدنيا ويا صابت يا اما خابت حسينا عجزك فاتكلمنا بالنيابه عنك ما انت ايدك ماسكه قلمي يعني كلامي ده من كتابتك اوعدك هبقى صوتك هبقى حزنك وابتسامتك وعهدك ان اللي سبقني هيبقى كانه سامعك يلا الثوره اكيد استنتجت ان لنا اهداف مش قصدي احنا بس لا ده كل واحد شاف حياه محتاجه تتغير افكار محتاجه تتطور بس مين في وسط الضلمه يطلع شعل عشان ينور طريق مقفول من جوه الضلمه بقول قلوب الناس اسودت من كلام حتى معقول وانا جيت علشان اتكلم عن اصوات ملايين بتقول هنحاول نعكس من نتيجه وضع غير مقبول Thank you everyone.
So hip hop it doesn't only belong here to the US. I guess hip hop is everywhere. Let's hear it again for Salah. And by the way Salah you didn't really need the stepping stone. Yeah. Our next speaker is a dear sister of mine. I remember Fatma told me like I always be angry in the beginning of the revolutions. So all my pictures was like I'm yelling and I looked really angry. Even my wife told me, Ayman, you have to smile a little bit. So Fatma, I remember at the when we kicked Mubarak out, we were celebrating in the street of New York, and Fatma told me, Ayman, I this is the first time I see you smiling, and you brought the tears of my eyes. And Fatma, you brought the tears of my eyes too, but by your support. Let's hear it for Sister Fatma. Yeah.
Hey guys, my name is Fatma. I'm here to support not only Egypt, but all countries that are fighting for their freedom and for their basic natural rights. I can't see my country being hurt this way and not saying anything about it. In Rigala, the real men in mosques stepped up and went to Tahrir and demanded rights. For that, they ended up getting shot in the eye and getting hit with tear gas bombs. Is this the way you treat us after we have been ruled for 30 years under your rule? The military killing the civilians In the end, we are all Egyptians. So all the people out there in Tahrir, Rabbana yahmiku ya rijalat mosk. Mish bas mosk, bas kull ad-dunya. And for the people that are against us, I just wanted to say we're the ones who started it and we're the ones who are going to end it. Not only in Egypt are they stepping up in Syria, and there's also in Syria, Greece, Libya, Yemen, and inshallah, the freedom of Palestine is going to be next. Yeah. And I have a couple of chants I want to say. Yeah, Tantawi Sahinom, and now Harda Echirium. Yeah, Tantawi Sahinom, and now Harda Echirium. Yeah, Mushantati. واحد answer.
Thank you, Fatma. Let's hear it again for the youth and Fatma! Our next speaker, she just arrived from Egypt. She was there, you know, from the beginning of the revolutions. She's been arrested because she was covering, she was doing a documentary about the revolutions. And she's here to keep, you know, to finishing the documentary. Again, as we all know, the documentary of the Egyptian revolutions is not only in Egypt. Part of it is here at home because they, you know, the American companies are sending weapons and sending tear gas to the military in Egypt. So let's hear it all for Sister Shaimea.
I remember back in February when the U.S. corporation media were trying to cover what is happening in Egypt. I didn't like the way they were portraying everything. And I went down to Tahrir Square with a big sign in English because I was trying to explain to them what is really going on. And then I met this American journalist. And I got detained with him because basically we were filming. The army was targeting like all the filmmakers, all the photographers. Anyone who tried to show the real picture was detained by the army. And that was even before Mubarak resigned. Since the beginning of the revolution, I was trying so hard to tell everyone that it's not about Mubarak. It's about the military dictatorship that was created since 1952, supported by the US. Egypt is the second largest recipient of foreign aid from the U.S. after Israel. And $1.3 billion goes to the military that is killing our brothers and sisters and detaining my friends. I was lucky. I was able to come here to tell you my story, but it's not the same case with my friends who are in military jails now. Over than 12,000 civilians were tried in front of military courts since the army took over, and the media never spoke about that. Nobody knew about that. There were army officers who joined us in Tahrir Square on April. They killed a few of them and they imprisoned the rest of them. So basically, you never get to know about all this kind of stuff until you meet someone who's actually was in Tahrir Square, someone who's on the ground, and you already get to see this perspective. Everyone knows about the most successful, beautiful 18 days of the Egyptian uprising, but nobody really thought about the fact that the revolution started after Mubarak resigned, not when Mubarak resigned. I came here because I'm working on a documentary movie since February until October about the Egyptian uprising, and I got invited to speak about my experience in the U.S. My concern was I really want the American people to know that your government is so very involved in our country. Your tax money goes to the Egyptian military, and you should deal with this. If you are fighting for this cause, you should be fighting with us too. I have some chance in English because I want like people who are non-Arabic speakers to be with us. So if you would repeat after me. From Cairo to NYC, stop police brutality. It's based in Pennsylvania, but they had an office here in New York. And basically, $1.3 billion are spent on weapons from the money of the American people. So we want to tell the U.S. government that not another nickel, not another dime, no more money for the army's crime.
Thank our sister Shaimea very much. Allow me to go on the margin of this demonstration, this greater demonstration. I'm going to discuss a point on the margin of this demonstration, which is some people are questioning our loyalty as American Egyptians, American Arabs, American Muslims, American, whichever we are. I want to point out to these great gentlemen here who are with us, who are Americans, who are not Egyptians, but it didn't hurt their loyalty to America to be with us here. Why is that? This is the key question. It's because they are on the side of the truth. They are on the side of justice. We are the same. We are Egyptian Americans, we are Muslims Americans, Coptic Americans. We are Americans first. And then all of us, we have heritage from somewhere else. Nobody would hurt the Puerto Ricans because they use the flags all the time in the cars. They are Americans. They are proud of being Puerto Ricans, Americans. We are proud to be anything else besides being Americans. Some people would question and say, is there a conflict between being American and some other nationality, some other religion or something? Definitely not, because you should be like those great people. You should be on the side of justice and truth. Loyalty is not to the land. Loyalty is not to the people. Loyalty is not to greed. Loyalty is to the just matter or the just case or cause. That's why those people are here. That's why we are here. We cherish our American heritage and our Egyptian or any other nationality's heritage. Those flags here are saying so. This flag here is the American flag and this is the Egyptian flag. No conflict whatsoever between what we believe in and believing in this country which gave us this home. And we flee our countries because we were suffering from what those people want to struggle out with. We flee our country to come here to exercise our freedom of religion, speech, and everything, exercise our first and all other amendments. No one would scare us or intimidate us by saying, oh, you are Egyptian, you are a Muslim, you are whatever it is. We are Americans. Our beliefs, as long as we love this country, gotta remain our belief. I'll address this in Arabic quickly. احنا في ناس بتشكك في وطنيتنا كأمريكان أو بتشكك فينا على أساس أن احنا ممكن نكون مسلمين أمريكان أو ممكن نكون مسيحيين أمريكان أو أي حاجة. بمنتهى البساطة بنلاقي البورتوريكنز وأي جنسيات أخرى بتحط الأعلام بتاعتها وماشيين، محدش بيوجه لهم تهمة الخيانة أو الولاء أو العداء للبلد. الناس العظام اللي موجودين هنا الامريكان واقفين معانا كمصريين، محدش قال لهم انهم خونه لامريكا عشان بيساندوا امريكا. ليه؟ عشان بيساندوا مصر. ليه بيساندوا مصر؟ لان مصر ليها قضيه، هي دي مفتاح القضيه، ان انا كامريكي او كمصري او كاي حاجه بساند الحق ولا شيء غير الحق. Thank you very much for listening. I'll present. Thank you very much. Sister Jomana, she's going to address the crowd for you. Thank you very much. اختنا جمانة هتتكلم دلوقتي.
Everyone, I'm here from Palestine, and I just wanted to remind everyone that we're not only here for Egypt, as much as I support Egypt, we are here for Syria, for Yemen, we came here for Libya, we will come here for Gaza, and for Palestine. I am so proud of the Arabs who finally are revolting against our megalomaniac dictators, and they have finally and successfully managed to put their names in the dumpsters of history, or as we say in Arabic, في مزاعب التاريخ, because that's where they belong. On the bones of our children, our husbands, our brothers, our family members, and our friends. We will no longer allow them to sell our freedom to add more money to their bank accounts while we starve for a loaf of bread. Down with Scaf, down with Assad, and down with Saleh, and down with Tantawi, and down with Zionism. We will not accept Egyptian gas to be given to Israel while poisonous gas is being spread at Egyptian protesters. I will end with a small part of a poem for if you would like to repeat after me. لا تصالح وإن منحوك الذهب. لا تصالح وإن منحوك الذهب. أترى حين أفقر عينيك ووضع ثم أثبت جوهرتين مكانهما. هل ترى هي أشياء لا تشترى. لا تصالح وليس سوى أن تريد. أنت فارس هذا المكان الوحيد. لا تصالح لا تصالح وإحنا لن نصالح. Thank you. Weeks ago. Thank you, everyone.
Assalamu alaikum. How are you, everyone? I'm here to report of 2 months I spent in Cairo and in Alexandria, Egypt, and what's going on now. We have to realize that they have relocated the regime. The regime is still in existence until now. Nothing has changed in Egypt. They have invested over $200 million in the past 6 months to buy weapons, cars, and artillery for the police to use it against the Egyptian people. The Egyptian people are suffering and they are investing money in weapons, in nerve gas, in poison gas. We have to understand that the revolution is still going. We're not gonna rest until we get this regime out. They are turning people against each other. We have to stand together. Muslims, Christians, Copts, Arabs, we are all here to defend our freedom. Egypt needs to be free.
Amen.
Relocating some of the regime does not change the regime. This regime needs to go down. Down, down. Scaf. The scaf needs to get down. This is very important, brothers and sisters. Everything is still the same. Nothing has changed. The system has to change. They change one person with another person from the same corrupt regime. Brothers and sisters, our sisters and brothers are being killed. Every day, people are being killed in Tahrir Square and in every square in Egypt just for our freedom. As American Egyptian, as Egyptian Americans, we stand with our people in Egypt. Thank you. Now let me introduce our brother Hamid from Syria, who gonna chant with us.
Thank you, sir. Such a gentleman. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Hamid, and I'm a member of the Syrian Americans for Democracy in New Jersey, a nonprofit organization. And today it's my honor to join my Egyptian brothers and sisters to support you and express that we share your sorrows. I feel, you know, this image and this picture has never, I'll never forget in my whole life when I saw the people in Tahrir Square, Midan al-Tahrir, waving the Syrian independence flag, the flag of the Syrian revolution. And we all were very tearful to see this image. And many of them were cheering for their cousins in Syria. We all one country. I always brag out since I was a little kid that Syria and Egypt was a country at one time. The Syrian Arab United, the Syrian Arab Republic. The United Arab Republic. I finally got it. So we will learn, what we try to learn from the Egyptian revolution is, yes, Egypt had won half of the revolution. They have toppled the president, but they have not toppled the regime. And that's what us Syrians will try to learn from this revolution. We will just do a small chance for it. In Syria, we say, بدنا نشيلك يا بشار بهمتنا الأوية سوريا بدا حرية. You guys gonna answer this, so we'll do some chants. بدنا نشيلك يا بشار بهمتنا الأوية سوريا بدا سوريا بدا وبدنا نشيلك يا مشير بهمتنا الأوية سوريا بدا مصر شو بدا مصر شو بدا وبدنا نشيلك يا مشير بهمتنا الأوية مصر شو بدا مصر شو بدا وبلا مشير وبلا طنطاوي وهالعصابة الهمجية مصر شو بدا مصر شو بدا ويا حرية وينك وينك يا حرية وينك وينك حط العسكر بيني وبينك حط العسكر بيني وبينك God bless Egypt, God bless Syria, God bless the revolution. We all love you, Syria loves you, Syria show gratitude for you. We will win this revolution. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.
I got it. I'm back again, guys. I'm also a member of Syrian Americans for Democracy, and I noticed as time went on, more and more of my Syrian brethren showed up to show support and appreciation from my organization. Is that we want to see more Syrian flags at the Egyptian rallies and demonstrations, and we want to see more Egyptian flags at the Syrian rallies and demonstrations.
اتحدوا، واذا كان في اي مشاكل في الانتخابات المره الجايه الرئاسيه من فضلكم حاولوا تدوروا على جماعات زي واحد زي انا. تعدينا جميع العقبات اللي في الانتخابات على الانترنت الجليتشز كلها وقدرنا ننتخب ان تايم، فبليز دوروا على المجموعات اللي زينا واحنا هندور عليكم على الانترنت وفيسبوك وان شاء الله الانتخابات الجايه كلنا ننتخب فيها. شكرا.
شكرا يا طارق، ودايما زي ما طارق قال اهم حاجه في حالنا مش اهم حاجه احنا منتمين لمين، وبلاش يعني نتكلم او ناخد وطنيه من اي حد، احنا كلنا واحد ومفروض the enemy is very clear for us. It's not about us, it's from the other side. So we have to know that. Our next speaker is the brother one from LRP.
Greetings, brothers and sisters. I wish I can speak in Arabic, but I want to speak in my broken English. I'm representing the League for the Revolutionary Party, the LRP. It's a small group of also transit workers, students, and team workers like myself. We're here in solidarity with the struggle of the Palestinians, the Libyans, the Syrians, and the Egyptians, and all the Middle East and the Arab and Congress parties. We want to
I'm just going to take this down.